It's actually quite refreshing to get back out here on Quattro Colinas today for our continued Red Deer grind. I know in terms of when the last Red Deer grind video came out, it's not been that long, but for me it's been almost a week because I had to prep for our Thanksgiving Day travel. But we're back here on Quattro today, and I'm excited to kind of continue along with our grind. We're around 2,200 stags in, something like that. And the last time that we basically left off, we had fired our last of the 12-12 rounds that we bought, and I think we bought about 1,500. We did a stream since then, and probably like a little bit, maybe half of a run when I got back, and that's kind of been it. But two stags up here at the top right lake, and actually as we're going to claim them, I've got a couple of little sort of announcements here. So the first is, we have a 12 Days of Christmas merch sale running right now for 15% off everything US only, and I guess Christmas kind of came early this year. I know it's still November, but you got to order by December 10th to make sure you get that before Christmas. So if you're interested, that link is going to be in the description below. Also, next Tuesday, we're going to have early access to the new map. So thanks to EW for doing that, as they've done for the past couple of years on new maps. We'll have an opportunity to take a kind of early look at everything that we're going to get to see with that upcoming content. So there's going to be a video dropping earlier in the day. And this is actually kind of the main reason that I wanted to sort of have almost an announcement section of this video. Following, I guess, our real life hunt that day, we're going to do a stream, so I'm going to guess 7 or 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. And just because rifle season is trying to take, like, all day hunts and then do videos on top of that, it takes quite a big toll. I think we're just going to kind of do streams on that early access for basically as long as it'll run. Something like a week is going to be my guess. And yeah, just basically streams around 7 or 7:30 p.m. Eastern. So there won't be videos, I guess, after Tuesday afternoon for something like a week. And I just think that's going to be easier, not only to show off as much of that new map as I can, but also to kind of, you know, hunt as much in real life as I can and hopefully get some content there as well. But as for today's video, we're going to kind of focus on a couple of spots that I feel like we've been missing, and also trying to somewhat perfect a couple of our strategies. So there are some red deer over there, and we could actually take a shot from here, but what I want to work on is fast traveling basically back past, and for whatever reason they'll run this way, and then getting into this tripod, and we may need to move it to make this work in the best way possible, but for the moment we're going to try this. Yeah, I feel like we're going to be a little bit kind of late till we get over there, so I'm going to have to move it over. I knew there was one, like, in this area, but I wasn't sure exactly how far away it was. So going for some of these shots can be tough, and actually the worst thing about it isn't trying to make these shots. Like, I don't mind that, doing it from the ground. There is some brush here, and obviously getting a tripod will help us to get above that, but the biggest issue really is the hunting pressure, and it wasn't much of an issue for a huge portion of this grind. I mean, like I said, over 2,000 kills in, and I haven't really run into the issue, but now, sometimes we get 3, 4, 5 stags in that particular area, and I really don't want to delete that zone. It's obviously a really good spot. I think we just killed the 3, and obviously we do not want to touch any more, but yeah, that's one of the kind of things, and unfortunately I don't think, I'm pretty sure I have tents with me. So we're going to have to change the loadout around. If I have the tents, which I think I should, I may, yeah, set them down and move that tripod, because I really, like I said, I don't want to delete that zone. It's a good one to get a bunch of stags quickly. So real quick, because I think we made good shots on all of them. Actually, I hadn't realized not only is that a level 7 stag, it's in the max weight range, which I don't know if that impacts spawns whatsoever now that I think of it. I guess just maybe for the sake of slightly quicker travel, or I guess I can't place a tent. We're going to have the max already placed. I was going to put one down and try to just hop back to the tripod, but I don't know. Sometimes when you fast travel within render of any animal, it seems like they'll just spook. So basically, like, if we have red deer that are rendered maybe down in this area, and then we fast travel back and we stay in the render, I think they would actually run off. So it might be best to not mess with any of that. Our other stag is laying right here. Anyway, I think that's going to be 5 stags into this hunt already. Just kind of moving right along, and definitely this top right lake continues to produce as many as, I don't know, sometimes 15 stags still as we go along. And actually, kind of to continue with the north area of the map, this next lake just to the west of where we were is kind of another one that we've recently discovered an area where red deer are drinking that I just simply did not know about. And I think we need to move that tent as well. So I guess we're doing as much kind of trying new stuff as we are adjusting our setup. But that's a big kind of aspect of the grind, and a big aspect of trying to stay efficient with the grind is really being, I guess, willing to adapt the setup. Like, once you have it set up, it can seem like that's all you have to do and then you just grind. But the red deer, and it doesn't really matter what species, the animals and herds will move around. And if you don't really try to change it up and basically follow them, you can lose a lot of time to trying to either run to where their new spot is, or in general eventually trying to locate all those new spots. So the way that we're going to handle this one, I think, is actually to move this tent probably over to this side somewhere. And we're going to run it for now just because it's kind of the way that the thing's set up. One maybe slower run where we go around and move things, and in the future we'll be all good. So one nice 7 from up here in this area has been pretty consistent in spawning like a max weight stag. We had one that was like the small big rack diamond, hard to kind of explain, but it was a 251 something here in a recent video. And then mostly mythicals or 7s pretty much every time, which I think is a good thing. Maybe that gives us better odds of specifically finding a great one there. Not sure if it really has anything to do with it, but definitely a spot to continue checking back to. And just a level 6 there that we hard shot at 262 meters. So glad that those shots are still landing after some time off. Now, this is actually the specific reason why I wanted to do a run around here and not just kind of spawn and move the tent without knowing what was going on. This is a herd of red deer, which has moved to a location where I really wasn't sure where they were. And rather than just kind of fast travel and, I don't know, throw the tent down here and just hope for the best, now I know. Basically, they drink right up there about 350 meters away, and it's not going to be too far from this other tent. So if I can place one right about here, maybe where we were standing, we should be good to kind of shoot straight across, fast travel over and claim them. And should they start drinking down in this area again, which is actually why I wanted to move stuff, we should be good for that side too. All that running for a level 4 red deer, but at least we kind of got that setup changed. And I mean, the idea is to make it more efficient in the long run. It's funny that we have the tents kind of clustered like that. I don't know, maybe we'll need to move them around. But we'll try the setup as it is and kind of go from there. Now, another spot that I've had some kind of interesting encounters with is down here at the Tornado Lake, and it's been very consistent. Basically, one stag or no stags. There's been very little variance from that pattern. But the last time I was down here, and I think it may have been on stream, there seemed to be a bunch of stag tracks, and I don't really know where they were coming from. So we may pick up this tent too, and just kind of see where we can place it better, because I don't think it's in the best spot. Or maybe the tent placement was not all that bad. The thing is, like, I usually go over there. Now, I do often start my runs basically at the far southeast lake here, and then I'll go straight over here to the Tornado Lake, and I guess there's a chance. And to go back to what I said, like, there were a bunch of stag tracks and fleeing tracks and stuff. They were all the way down here on this end, and maybe because I'm looking at it, there's kind of a mountain here. They would rest in that time frame before their morning drink zone, so maybe they just kind of rest on that hill. Now this, there must be a stag here too, and we would have spawned within render of that, so that one, or within 200 meters of that rather, so it wouldn't have rendered for us. That does kind of make our kind of options for where to place the tent a little more tricky. Although I think probably the best move is to place it kind of in this area. So let's see if we can find a way to get them both, actually. Rather nice of the mythical to turn for us. So in the normal circumstance, the way to go is to take the more difficult shot first, so we'll do that. And maybe not the best follow-up in history, but it'll be a long shot. And then I'll get both of those stags down. So what I think I'm going to do is just kind of throw the tent down somewhere up here in the trees a bit, and only because it's a little more level. And basically, the way that I'd like to approach this, if there are going to be those two different drink zones, is spawn there, shoot the couple of stags over on this end, and then ideally kind of turn around, shoot whatever stag is over on this side, and then it's a quick fast travel back, claim, and move on. Now, of course, it is going to be a little bit difficult depending on where the stag decides to drink at. And that's kind of why I was getting that shot off quickly. As soon as he got behind those rocks and behind the tent, we would have had some hitboxes that would have blocked us from getting our shot in there. So that may need some fine tuning. Maybe that's not the best placement for the tent. But for the moment, it worked. And three stags down here at the Tornado Lake, I couldn't tell you the last time we did that. And actually, it's going to be two golds again because that was a gold level 6. Now, anytime that I've had a lot of stags, they've usually been down in here, but oddly enough, it seems the Rodeer and Mouflon of Moot, that's not really where they've been. And I don't, like, I never delete zones down here. I don't shoot enough stuff to delete zones. I'm not sure what causes something like that to happen. I was sure, yeah, I knew I saw the body of that mythical land somewhere. It's up here in the brush, but I really don't understand why sometimes those things move. At the very least, we're able to adapt and kind of just continue doing our thing. Well, that didn't work too good. I guess at some point the level 6 fell in the water, and I didn't know about it. So we had to run all the way back, because clearly I ran right past him as he was floating here, and I didn't see him. But yeah, I guess in the future it should be efficient, but that's something else to look out for. And actually, I think on that note, we've gone through all the locations that I need to change. Now, in this particular instance, this mythical is walking back, and I believe he must have been, like, in his zone, and again with the tent placement, we spot within 200 meters and he wasn't visible. Now, this spot may be worth kind of taking a look at and moving stuff around. As of late, it has been spawning multiple stags again, so I may need to take a look at that, but that's one where I kind of need to maybe understand where they're spawning better, because they seem to be at two different locations, and it also is 922, so we're a little bit late to be making any major decisions with this one, but at least we have the information there, and it is good to see another big stag. I don't know the last one that we shot at this lake, so that's definitely good, but this will now make two red deer hunting videos in a row without any kind of substantial kills. We had the melanistic, I guess, three videos ago, and then just a couple of mythicals in both the last video and this one, so I guess there's two ways to look at that. One way is that the grind has really not been producing in terms of, you know, high-scoring ones that would reach diamond. The other way is, and this is a very, you know, kind of anecdotal but optimistic view, a lot of people have said, like, their grind seems to kind of dry up, and then a great one appears. So as we're crossing the, you know, 22-2250 mark into this grind, hopefully the great one is just around the corner. I'd love to have that done before the new map. And of course, with the early access, like I said, next Tuesday, things are going to be getting kicked off there. It would be just amazing to have it done before that. So this weekend, we're going to, you know, kind of try, and we'll see where we get to. But anyway, that is going to do it for this video. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.